Welcome to the Crash Course on Conflicting Interests in the Legal Transnational Space. The nature of transnational law is complex, as it involves actors who often have conflicting interests in relation to their national ideological interests versus their legal and professional duties when acting for globalized bodies that span multiple jurisdictions. What if a lawyer in Israel was asked to work for an organization that funds and aids Palestine, for example? What does a lawyer in Taiwan do when it works with an entity such as the World Health Organization that does not recognize Taiwan as an independent nation? Conflicting national versus professional interests are brought into question. As part of our exploration into this matter, we will ponder the work of Kate Galloway, John Flood and Melissa Kasten, who exposed the issue with the commodification of globalized legal work in their treatise, The Global Lawyer. The commodification of legal work has left a gaping white hole in the ethics department of international legal work in terms of establishing a moral framework. Legal practice prides itself in putting the client's interests as a top priority. Confidentiality at law also means lawyers must keep specific information secret. When dealing in the transnational space, what are lawyers to do if they stumble across information that poses as a national threat to their own country of citizenship? How do the policies of a transnational body operate alongside the non-binding national duties of a citizen working within that space? Interestingly, many transnational bodies ask workers to declare potential conflicts of interest. The World Health Organization is one such body. The WHO requires external experts to declare conflicting interests before undertaking work. Thus, an ethical question arises as to the rights and moral obligations workers are required to relinquish in undertaking international legal work. If they stumble across information that may jeopardize their home country, do they have a national duty to expose it? Ironically, the international legal stage is built by the very transnational companies these lawyers would work for. So who do they go to gain accountability for corruption taking place in their own organizations should it occur and put their own country at risk? Like any jurisdiction, there tends to be accountability mechanisms. For example, the Ombudsman here in Australia offers government accountability. When governments do something wrong, international courts can themselves interfere to stop corruption. So when an international body is caught doing something wrong, how do lawyers deal with the problem, especially when the problem involves information that may pit one nation against another? Should discretion be used? Like any political organization, there is often corruption, and especially in transnational bodies that are heavily represented by specific nations or agents with particular preferences or bias. According to Terry Narden, one can of course criticize international law from the point of view of other ethical systems. On the one hand, international law is designed to harmonize otherwise conflicting polities and offer a space to collaborate and seek world peace. So perhaps a lawyer working in the international space should submit to the governments of that international body and place their national interests aside in order to operate without bias. On the other hand, this may be an idealistic and not a pragmatic approach. Due to the reality of corruption, the international lawyer must be sensitive to these issues and then act in accordance with a greater moral principle to see world peace manifest. The greater principle of morality in seeking world peace and harmonization should ultimately drive the lawyer's actions. It is worth noting that if a national interest or corporate interest drives their behavior, they may be counterintuitive in their job role, as they undercut the purpose of the job role on an international stage, which is to preference harmonization between nations. The obvious critique to that would be the fact that if corruption or other procedural error is found in a transnational body, the lawyer would need to operate on higher moral principles in order to resolve the issue and produce long-lasting international harmony. It is worth noting that international whistleblower protections may offer security to global lawyers who discover misconduct. Good judgment, discretion, professionalism, and a preference to expose corruption to see international harmonization should thus be characteristics employed by borderless lawyers, particularly when they work in politically charged environments. A borderless lawyer's national interest therefore should not be overlooked in their work capacity. This applies particularly in the context where corruption is found.